Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, if you guys did not know, well, there is a breaking story that is being posted all over at least the US, and I'm pretty sure it's all over Germany. I wanted to talk about it because it's actually pretty interesting. Something kind of a little jarring, I guess, but also something that doesn't really affect any of us. It's just, it's interesting. It's definitely an interesting story. Wanted to cover it really quick and go from there. If you guys are new to the channel, willkommen. If you guys are returning viewers, willkommen zurück. We post videos every single day, oder jeden Tag. All I ask is that you guys abonniert diesen Kanal und like the video. Bitte vielen lieben Dank für eure Unterstützung. Das bedeutet mir viel. Let's go ahead and check this article out and see exactly what we're getting ourselves into, because this is very interesting. I feel like you guys want to. So it says, a German man is keeping $60 million in Bitcoin from police by never revealing his password. And here in the story, it says, the wonderful thing about Bitcoin is many of its apparent benefits, like the ability to be anonymously owned and securely transferred, are also the things that often create situations like this. Police in Germany have seized more than 50 million euro, or $60 million, in Bitcoin, but they can't access any of it because, as Reuters reports, the person they took it from won't tell them his password. The man in question was sentenced and has already served his jail time for covertly installing Bitcoin mining software on people's computers. But throughout the entire process, he never shared a peep about how German authorities would get in. We asked him, but he didn't say, is the explanation Reuters was offered by a prosecutor. It presents a big and possibly obvious question. Can you really see something, particularly money, that you can't access or use? Then the even more glaring issue is how often passwords, pins, and other collective absence pop up in stories about Bitcoin, illegal or otherwise. There was a recent story in the New York Times about a programmer with his own Bitcoin fortune locked away in a secure hard drive that revealed an amazing statistic. Around 20% of Bitcoin in existence today, totaling around 140 billion, are completely lost or locked up in wallets with lost passwords, meaning they're completely inaccessible. So maybe this German Bitcoin enthusiast is sticking to the people who had it locked up, or maybe he's simply forgotten his password. Reuters reports that prosecutors have ensured that the man cannot access his Largesse, but they cannot access it either. I think it's safe to say the pile of lost Bitcoin just got a lot larger. The galaxy, okay, hold on. Anyways, that's pretty much it. So, guys, this is very interesting. This kind of goes into like more of a privacy act kind of thing. I was looking at this article and I'm like, man, well, Europe already has the privacy act, so trying to force someone to give up their password for anything is probably violates that issue, no matter what the person's been involved in. But it does beg the question, depending on how serious the offense is, right, for certain crimes, do you think people should have to fork over their passwords, or should there be a back door to getting in people's accounts to get exclusive access to your personal information? If there's reasonable suspicion that you're up to no good, or reasonable suspicion that someone else is up to no good, I feel like that shouldn't be a thing, honestly, because it is very invasive. Because let's say you're not doing anything and someone just decides to suss you out for some reason, and all of a sudden your account gets hacked into because there is a back door to getting into your account. That would be absolutely crazy. But the fact, I just thought it was hilarious that, you know, we have, oh God, hold on. I just thought it was hilarious that you have all this money in the world, right? Like in Bitcoin, and it's lost. There's a guy here in America that lost $200 million in Bitcoin that he had won years ago. And the thing is, he lost it because he just forgot his password. There's no like, forgot your password? Just send it, we'll send you an email and you can reset it. No, there's none of that. Like if you forgot your password, you just forgot your password, bro. Like that's it. Like that is super secure. So what are you guys' thoughts and feelings on this? This is just a really quick video. You know, talking about this kind of issue. It's not really, like I said, it's not a huge deal or anything, but I thought it was very bizarre that this did happen. And honestly too, like how would they use the money? Like, I mean, like when they confiscate this 50 some odd million dollars, where does the money go? Has it ever been like a question for you guys? Like whenever, like, you know, governments confiscate money, whether it be the German government, the U.S. government, whatever, where does the money go? Do they put it back in the state or something? Or do they, like, I don't know, pay their employees more? I don't know. But these are all questions that maybe one of you guys has the answers to. Like, comment, subscribe if you're new. We post videos every single day here. And I really appreciate the support. I'm going to talk to you guys very soon. Bis später. Ciao, ciao. Well, 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 what a pleasure it is to see all of your beautiful faces at the end of this lovely video. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'm sure you know, as I've mentioned in the past, we do have a Discord that's linked in the description down below, and we would love to have you a part of the world's greatest community ever. Bray Gang. Yes, if you've made it to this point in the video, you're officially a part of the community. So go ahead, join the Discord server. Link is in the description down below. And we also have other social media as well, like Instagram, Twitter. We're live. We go live on Twitch quite often as well. So it would behoove you to, you know, go ahead and subscribe to the Twitch channel at twitch.tv/JamesBrayGang. Join the cause and be a part of the greatest, literally the greatest community ever. Okay, it's simple. Just go ahead and do those little things. We're trying to grow on all these little platforms and everything, and it really means a lot. Now, I know you guys stumbled up across the channel and you're like, what does this guy post? Like, what kind of content does he post? Reactions, vlogs, pretty much whatever comes to my mind. All right, it's random content. I don't know what I'm gonna be posting 10 years from now, but I do know that you can stick along for the journey, and it really means a lot. Now, for every single person that subscribes and follows all of the accounts that I have made, and all the links will be in the description down below, that's an automatic entry for any future giveaways I decide to have. I'll remind you when the giveaways take place, but you'll be surprised what I will be giving away because you guys have supported me so much up to this point, and it's only right that I do the same thing back. Thank you guys so much for being amazing, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. Peace.